Committee will come to order. We meet today to consider the United States-Taiwan Expedited Double Tax Relief Act. This is a busy day in the Senate, many committees conducting business. So for the information centers and staff, let me explain how I and Ranking Member Crapo will proceed. We're each going to deliver an opening statement. Other members are then welcome to deliver opening statements of up to 2 minutes. Once opening statements have been given, we'll introduce the panel and allow members to ask questions of the committee staff. After that, we'll consider amendments to the mark. We will then vote on whether to report the mark for the information of members and staff, and we've discussed this with members on both sides. We plan to hold the vote to report the bill around 10:45, and we'll let members know if the time for that vote changes. If a quorum for a vote is not present, we will vote when we have a quorum. With that, we will turn to opening statements. Now, the committee is convened today to vote on bipartisan tax legislation, the U.S.-Taiwan Expedited Double Tax Relief Act. This legislation relieves double taxation on investment between the United States and Taiwan. Today's legislation has been developed jointly by myself and Ranking Member Crapo, along with the Ranking Member of the Ways and Means Committee, Chairman Jason Smith, and Ranking Member Neal. For months leading up to today, the four of us have been working closely together to get this done, and I want to thank those three colleagues for their strong support. It is not every day that the bipartisan leadership of both tax writing committees come together in this kind of fashion. But this legislation is hugely important to American workers and national security. Let me highlight the reason why the bill has generated such strong bipartisan support. First and foremost, the momentum behind the proposal comes from the fact that the Senate, on a bipartisan basis, fully supports strengthening America's economic partnership with Taiwan. Taiwan is a critical trading partner. For example, there are deep ties between Oregon and Taiwan developed through decades of trade along the Pacific Rim. My state has understood the importance of supporting Taiwan for a long time. The Senate recently demonstrated its strong support for Taiwan when it unanimously passed the first trade agreement signed under the U.S.-Taiwan Initiative on 21st Century Trade. This legislation is part of a plan to strengthen America for generations to come, particularly by supercharging chips making in America. This has been especially important to this committee, where we authored on a bipartisan basis the $24 billion in the new CHIPS tax credit to support fab construction here in our country. Taiwan is a critical partner in this venture. Over the last 5 years, $45 billion were invested in the United States from Taiwan in the semiconductor sector. We anticipate billions of dollars more, translating into good-paying jobs across the country. To ensure that our country continues to grow these investments in America, relief of double taxation between the United States and Taiwan is a crucial next step. We don't want these investments to fall through or go to other countries because we're not providing double tax relief. This is the same type of double tax relief provided to other major trading partners, and other countries are providing this relief to Taiwan already. We can't allow double tax issues to hamper any growth in our domestic semiconductor industry, and this is why Senator Crapo and I have felt so strongly about this issue. For U.S. workers who need to occasionally travel abroad, our bill can provide especially strong benefits. Let's say somebody from Portland needs to go to Taipei for 3 weeks as part of their job training. Right now, they may have to fill out a Taiwanese tax return and deal with all kinds of U.S. tax filing headaches. Once we get this done, they go to Taiwan for a short business day, do their job, come home, and not worry a bit about it. There's no time to waste. By putting double tax relief directly into the tax code, if things go well, we're talking about months, not years, for the relief for U.S. workers, U.S. investments, and U.S. companies. Not only is Taiwan a critical trading partner, it's a democracy that shares our values and faces a growing threat. The Chinese Communist Party continues its efforts to intimidate and isolate Taiwan through diplomatic and economic coercion and the use of force. China has been ratcheting up its military capabilities along Taiwan's coastline, from updating its military bases near the Taiwan Strait to sending warships and warplanes near the island on a daily basis. These aggressive activities affect the United States and our allies. As a global leader in manufacturing semiconductors, the chips used in TVs and iPhones, but also in advanced weapons and military equipment, Taiwan plays a key role in the security of democratic nations. I'll put the rest of my remarks on these national security issues into the record. Beijing's activities in the region could lead to global disruptions in trade, investment, and finance. As cross-strait tensions increase, the United States Congress has to work to help stabilize the region. Let me close by saying members across this committee have been strong friends of Taiwan, and on this issue, no one has been stronger than Senator Menendez as chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee. Senator Menendez and I have been working very closely together on a framework to achieve the goals that I've described here. We've had a long and strong partnership with these kinds of issues, working on our committee's shared priorities in the past, and I very much appreciate his leadership on this issue as well. Our unique relationship with Taiwan requires a unique approach to double tax relief as well. It's novel, but more importantly, it's fast. If Congress can get this done, Americans will see more shovels in the ground, more semiconductors coming off the factory line, and more good-paying jobs. I hope everyone on the Finance Committee is going to support this bipartisan and bicameral legislation. With that, I'll turn things over to Senator Crapo.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thanks to your staff also for their efforts as well.